With the ever-increasing food prices, schools across the country are struggling to feed learners with quality and adequate food. Reports indicate that many of these schools opt for cheaper yet substantial food supplies in order to cut down on the expenses. This, however, puts millions of learners' lives at risk of acquiring serious health complications such as stunted growth, cancer, among other ailments. During an engagement with school heads and food suppliers, the Uganda National Bureau of Standards emphasized the need for schools to feed their learners on only fortified foods.
The first time food gets to the school, it must be certified food. So that guarantees that on arrival, we know that we have gotten good food. The food that goes there in the first place must come when it's what? Safe and of quality. Then managing it and keeping it there is another responsibility of the school, which we have agreed.
You have to supplement the grains and the flour our kids eat for them to have a full, balanced, healthy and safe food.
Despite being a food basket for the region, Uganda's foods are said to be lacking in quality, and this has been attributed to factors such as poor post-harvest handling, poor packaging, transportation and storage, among other factors. UNBS notes that there are only about 200 certified food suppliers in the country.
And I think you saw incidences of rejection of food, both on the market, but also within the region. But for now, I can assure you, and I've told all schools, we have enough food, good food now, milled grain, that can feed these schools, and there will be enough to sustain that going forward. We have now over 200 millers, both large scale, medium and small, to be able to provide schools with all the food, the good food they need.
Meanwhile, administrators of government-aided schools say they lack adequate funds to feed their learners, since the government insists learners in UPE and USE schools should not pay any fees at school.
So we hope by that decision, cabinet is committed to make sure they increase the money to cater for everything a child needs for the teaching learning process. Unless that is done, then the decision remains hanging and can never be implemented.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.